Hi all, I'm Uday. I am the MD of eNate in India with responsibility to build the business across the APAC region. And because of my job, I meet a lot of different businesses and I see some recurring themes which businesses seem to be experiencing when they're deploying RPA. And a lot of these challenges I hear from different COEs, from the business side of businesses as well, I mean from the operation side as well. And I thought I should consolidate that and put together some slides so that you know we can kind of talk about what those challenges are and what you might potentially do about them. Now, some of these problems may be things you're familiar with. Maybe this is the way you have set it up as well. It's possible that you haven't, in which case, just ignore parts of this, but hopefully you will find something which you know, which resonates with how you're working as well. Now, typically when you set up you know, a bot landscape or some kind of bot infrastructure, what you do is you have the ops teams or the business teams sending work through to the bots by you know, putting things into maybe shared drives, maybe sending an email which a bot then picks up and processes, or you may be putting you know, things into an Excel and then feeding that into the bot somehow. Now, typically what happens is that business teams do that and then you've got a separate technical team. It can be called a COE team and some businesses call it L1 support or any other kind of you know, bot management team ultimately, which then on the side runs your bot infrastructure. Now, in a lot of places, way that is designed is one bot might be working on one process. I've seen that now in quite a few places. And occasionally, if depending on how mature your you know, bot implementation is, you might even have bots working across multiple processes, but it's quite common to have one bot working on one process. And then you have some of the output as well, which the bots are you know, then writing out somewhere which the technical teams then can view. Now, the problem with this kind of design is that business teams who actually use it, use the bots, they cannot actually see the bots, right? So they don't have a line of visibility of what's actually happening. And that poses a lot of challenges. So things like the business team can't, you know, understand the capacity, deploy it where it's actually required. They can't manage the prioritization of work which the bot is executing. The COE teams might have set up various types of schedules, which they, you know, where the bot kind of comes up, looks for work, and then shuts down, things like that. But that may not work for the business because ultimately business is worried about their SLAs and what, you know, their service delivery commitments are. Other than that, there's also a problem with SLAs. So when business teams send work to the bot side, then they completely lose control of when the bot might actually finish something and send it back. And that then is not aligned with how the business wants to run, right? So ultimately a whole bunch of challenges coming out of that. And what happens with that is that actually the operational ownership of the bots is not with the business, it's ultimately with the bot teams, right? And because of which the business still needs answers to all these questions. And then that means a big comms overhead between business and COE. And that really not being very useful for anyone. Now, the challenges on the COE team side is that they have to constantly manage this comms overhead. They need larger teams than ideally should be the case to run their bot infrastructure, so it's more expensive. Bot programming is a little bit more complicated because they need to manage all the exceptions, write it out, make sure that they are you know, monitoring everything appropriately so that they can feed stuff back. They have to proactively manage the broad infrastructure, not only when something goes wrong. So they have a lot of places, businesses have set up what they call control centers or control rooms, where there might be different you know, TVs on the walls and stuff like that, where they are just looking at, you know, there's a team just looking at what the bots are doing. And their job is to basically spot if something is not working correctly so that they can you know, report that to the business before the business detect that things are not progressing, right? A last problem, which I see, I mean, not the last, but certainly another problem which I see is, and this may not be the case with your business, but now I've seen it in a few places and it's a big issue, is that since the business perceives the bots as something which the bot teams own, if the bots go down, then business expect the bot technical teams to finish business tasks, right? And business teams and bot team and technical teams, sorry, may not know how to do those, the functional tasks which are involved. So this becomes much harder. And there's a bit of finger pointing going on. Now, what happens at the end of all this? Ultimately, I mean, it's an RPA initiative, an automation initiative, and ultimately all this results to a bad RPA experience, lower utilization, lower adoption, and basically all of this happening at a higher cost. Hopefully some of those are things which you have seen in your business as well. How do you kind of deal with this now? So a lot of businesses doing things, and this whole industry is evolving, so there will be other businesses which come out with ways to do it. But Innate is now addressing all of these challenges. These are live in quite a few places and doing really well. So with Innate, how you kind of tackle these situations are that your mechanism to feed into the bots from the business side remains the same. People still send out emails, they put in files, so on and so forth. But what happens is that each one of these things automatically creates a piece of work in Innate, right? Now, with that, what happens is that everything is available in Innate in one platform, so all the demand which the business is generating, and you have all your business users and your bot users all working off a single platform, right? Now, this by definition means that they can now start seeing each other. There is possibility to, you know, for humans to understand what the bots are doing, and bots and humans to suddenly they become interoperable. So when humans finish, they can hand things off to bots. If bots can't do something, they can give it back to humans, and they can then sort of exchange, work, or as it progresses through a process, they can get involved at various different touch points. Now, what this does is it shifts the operational ownership of the bots back to the business guys, right? Now, this is a big thing because this means that business now own how the bot is performing, what it's doing, and a whole bunch of things around that. Now, even in the case of exceptions, if something goes, if I come to the bot support team, their role becomes much more, you know, infrastructure kind of based. So they need to get involved if something really goes wrong, right? Not otherwise. Now, if you look at what happens when exceptions are there. Now, a lot of times, I mean, if I were to just quickly classify exceptions as business exceptions or technical exceptions, business exceptions being where the ops teams haven't, you know, sent in some data, they've sent in wrong kind of files, or something, you know, along those lines, which is not really a technical issue. Then what happens in a regular setup is that the technical teams have to, you know, evaluate each exception and then work out what went wrong. But with a platform like Innate, you have the choice of sending business exceptions straight back to the business team. I mean, ultimately they have not, you know, done something right, so you can just hand it back to them. So Innate automatically lets you send an exception to the business team, and only when there's things like infrastructure issues or things where the technical teams actually need to get involved, that's when they have to kind of step in. Otherwise, not really. That I mean, you can imagine what kind of workload that reduces as well. Now, what are the advantages? Ultimately, business has complete visibility, right? What's the status of the bots? And I'll show you a screenshot from the product shortly, but what is the status of the bots online, offline? What are they working on, prioritization, all of that, right? Including things like SLAs. So now suddenly you are in control of what SLAs and ordering as well bots work against. And that kind of gets handed back to the business team so they can run it based on what their business needs are, right? They can also do various things like understand the entire transaction history, right? So what came in, who touched it in the human world, who touched it in the bot world, what was done where, what were the timelines, everything in one view. They can also, the last thing is, which I want to talk about is metrics are all out of the box in real time. So in the old world, you have, you know, business teams asking the bot teams to collate a whole bunch of data, and then that data is, you know, to large scale reliable, but you can't really say because a lot of manual involvement is going into that. But with a platform, an orchestration platform like Innate, it's all available in real time. Next advantage for the COE teams is ultimately it's a much leaner team. And they have to only handle exceptions which are technical in nature. There's no comms overhead with the business, and they are much more reactive as a team without any overhead of doing tasks which they shouldn't need to do as well, right? So you can just run your a very slick RPA infrastructure without having a massive team to support it. And ultimately, what does all of this mean? All of this really means is that you have made bots kind of like humans and work along with the human operations team in a way that is just much more business friendly, and the whole RPA experience is much better, and businesses can then drive the direction of that automation program. So what does all of this look like? That's the next slide. So this is a view from the product. If I were to just explain it a bit, you've got all the humans, which you see as part of your human team. You can see all the bots as part of your, which are working alongside your humans. all the work which is assigned to the bots. So that team of four bots is working on this queue. You can see what each individual bot member of your team is working on. You can see what sort of SLAs they're working against, right? So by when will each piece of work get done? You can change the ordering of this. So you're allowing your human team members to drive and change the ordering of things which bots do. You can even see things like what is the potential pending time of the pending workload which bots have. And if I kind of go to the bottom here, Enid is also agnostic of which bot you use. So what that means is that if you have multiple bot vendors, then you can also view all your various different bot farms. These are bot farms, the UiPath bot farm here and a Automation Anywhere bot farm. And what this is basically letting you do is look at one view across your people, across your bots, across your work, across your SLAs, and the whole thing in one view. Hopefully that gives you a sense of what challenges are there if you do a little bit of traditional RPA type of deployment and where it can get to. And this is working really well with a lot of really large businesses. Thank you. Hope you enjoyed that. And if you have any questions, please drop us a line and we'll be glad to connect. Thanks.